y no finalizan las actividades, se ayudan entre ellos y pueden tener, pueden terminar con las actividades a tiempo, y solo algunos trabajan. And the teacher chooses the second option. Que se ayudan entre ellos y pueden terminar con las actividades a tiempo. And the last, the last question was, ¿qué estrategias usas para que el trabajo en grupo tenga resultados positivos? And the teacher answer was, les doy la posibilidad a los alumnos que se agrupen según su afinidad, que no necesariamente tengan que trabajar, que reunirse en una casa, sino que se organizan usando WhatsApp, el tiempo en la escuela, etc. Y que se repartan la tarea entre los miembros del grupo. También trabajan de a dos según compañeros de banco. So, with the information I collected, I changed the way I organized students. I gave them the possibility to group with someone they got on well with. So before, when I applied the new method, before they started to work, I suggested that each member of the group should be assigned a task. For instance, one should read, another should write, and another student should look words up in the dictionary. So, what do the findings tell me about my research questions? First of all, that the students engaged positively with the group work activity, and they felt motivated and comfortable about working in groups because they were helping and supporting each other. Also, all members of the group participated and contributed. So now I can realize that I didn't give them the opportunity to choose who they want to work with. So as a reflection, I think that this action research experience helped me to realize that it is important to take my students' opinions into account when planning.